So, low light photography. Man, I really wanted to talk about what I've learned in low light photography throughout these years. And to be exact, it's low light street photography. Some people might call it night photography or even cyberpunk photography. So for those who don't know, low light photography is just basically photography with limited light source. And obviously, photography is all about light, and once you have very limited light source, it can be very difficult sometimes. And once you master low light photography, you'll even be better at taking daytime photography because of how much you got more sensitive towards light sources. So let's first take a look at what equipments you'll need to take better low light photographies. Well, everybody knows that if you're gonna take low light photography, you're gonna have a slower shutter speed, and therefore you will need a tripod. But in my case, I don't actually ever use a tripod. First off, it's just all about your personal taste when it comes to the image quality, because I don't really mind grainy image to begin with. And plus, well, I'm using a Sony camera and they're really good at low light photography. So I can boost my ISO up to like 2000, 3000 even. You will start to see some grain when it reaches 2000. And if you really don't like grain, you can still remove the noise in post-production. It's not bad at all. I've tried it and the result is pretty good. So, but there's always an equipment that I would use when it comes to low light photography, which is the lens. So the lens that I would prefer to use when it comes to low light is a prime lens. Because with low light photography, you want to keep your image as clean as possible. And with a prime lens, because of how little glass they have in between, and so when the light comes in, it's much more cleaner than other longer lens that you have. Also, when using a prime lens, it usually comes with a bigger aperture. For example, mine, I'm using a Sigma 30mm 1.4, and the aperture is just really big. And when it comes to like really low light environment, I cannot boost my ISO and my shutter speed is like the slowest. That's when I just put my aperture into 1.4. But generally, when I'm taking street photography, I don't really enjoy having a very shallow depth of field. I kind of like to see everything in focus. Now, when you get your equipments right, make sure you take your pictures in RAW. With RAW, it just saves a lot of details that you don't even notice when you're shooting it. There are times that I already think that a picture is really good when I shoot it, but when I put it into camera raw and start to edit the photos, I notice that there's so much details that I didn't even notice when I was taking, and it just makes the picture much better. Whereas if I took it in JPEG, I wouldn't have able to bring those details out. So I really suggest you to take in raw. So now it comes to the shooting. When it comes to shooting, the first thing you're gonna do is locate your light source. For me, there's two ways of dealing with this light. First one is if you're doing portrait, and second one is if you're doing street photography. So when you're doing portrait, you're gonna use the light to shape your subject. So there's all kind of light source that you can use. There are light source from an ATM machine, from a street light. I've also used light of a screen coming off from a fashion, like a clothing store. Usually when you're taking portrait in a studio, you kind of have to change the light according to the subject. But when you're doing these street portraits, you're gonna have to move your subject according to the light. For me, it's just very exciting and very fun to play with it because the result can be very different every time you take it. So as I mentioned earlier, when you're taking portrait, you're using the light source to light your subject. But when you're taking street photographies, like actual street, those light is gonna be part of your subject. So as you can see, I've taken a picture of a bus stop and there's light coming off from the bus stop itself. When the light source itself is part of your subject, it's always fun to take another subject to interact with the light. I always like to take pictures of motorbikes and people walking as part of the subject. So you always see a light on top and maybe someone at the bottom, or there are people or motorbike passing in front of your light source. So obviously there's no right or wrong when it comes to these kind of things, but this is just how I do it and you can try it out. So during the shooting, you might notice that your focus is not always accurate. So that's why I would suggest to use manual focus over autofocus. I guess it depends on the camera. Some of them work better than the other. You just have to try it out. Now, the last tip I would give is to find contrast. It can be anything. It can be color, it can be shadow versus highlight, it can be shape. Specifically in low light photography, because most part of the image is dark. That's why in order to make your image more interesting, you gotta have this contrast going on. If you look at my picture, you'll notice that I always have these blue versus red, green versus pink, and that's what makes the picture a lot more interesting. You also notice that the contrast can be a shape as well, such as a silhouette of a human in front of a light, or As I mentioned earlier, a motorbike in front of a light, you see this contrast between the person in front of the light and the light itself. And this silhouette of people often give the image a very moody look. So after I start to do low light photography, my daytime pictures start to change as well because of what I've learned in low light photography. Like, I start to really appreciate to see every detail in the image and try to make the use of it as much as possible. Because when I'm taking low light photography, there's not much subject that I can play with. That's why I try to make everything as interesting as possible. But when I start to take daytime photography, I can literally see everything. So it kind of make me want to make everything look interesting, and that's why my pictures start to become better and better, I guess. I really hope you guys learned something from this video, and I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you next time. Bye.